Now we're going to drill down into the details and make many of the notions we've been talking about more precise. First, we need to define running time. We'll let M be a Turing machine, single tape, multi-tape, random access, the definition works for all of them. And we assume that it halts on all inputs. The running time, then, is a function over the natural numbers, where f of n is the largest number of steps taken by a machine for an input string length of n. We can extend this definition to machines that don't halt as well by making their runtime infinite. We're always considering the worst case here. Let's illustrate this idea with an example. Consider this single tape machine that takes in a binary input and tests whether the input contains a 1. On encountering a 0, it simply loops back into this Q0 state and moves the head to the right. When it encounters a 1, it accepts and halts immediately. And if it encounters the blank symbol, indicating the end of the input, without ever having encountered a 1, it rejects. Let's figure out the running time for a string of length 2. We need to consider all possible strings of length 2, so we'll make a table like this and count the number of steps. The largest number of steps is 3. We had to read the 0, the 0, and the blank after it. And so that then is the overall running time. F of 2 is equal to 3.